evening, ladies and gentlemen. While I'm Falcha or Rivka, then you could you inshallah you show. You're all most welcome to Ballyroan Library tonight for the launch of the 1916 Women Rising Up exhibition. It's an enormous privilege to be Mayor of South Dublin County for the centenary of the Rising, and as we remember all of those who fought and died in 1916. For me, the legacy of previous generations cannot be left to gather dust in a museum or taken out and paraded on the streets for a day. It has to be a living legacy. This exhibition, which I'm launching here this evening, is a most fitting tribute to the memory of the women of 1916. The exhibition is a collaboration between my colleague, Deputy Mayor, Councillor Francis Noel Duffy, South Dublin Libraries and South Dublin County Council's Centenary Programme of Events to celebrate the forgotten lives of the women who played a pivotal role in the events of 1916. It's fantastic that the launch this evening will be followed by a talk by historian Liz Gillis on women of the Irish Revolution. Welcome, Liz. Francis was first introduced to these women in 2004 when he was surveying Kilmainham Jail with students from the Dublin School of Architecture where he lectures. Niamh O'Sullivan from the Office of Public Works facilitated a tour of the jail where she spoke passionately about 300 plus forgotten women who were interned for their anti-treaty beliefs in the West Wing. Niamh was particularly motivated by the women who did not have a national profile or privilege, like Nurse Elizabeth O'Farrell, who accompanied Padraig Pearce in the official handing over of the surrender documents. The women involved in the struggle for Irish political independence between 1916 and 1923 were part of a long tradition of Irish patriotism. No less than the men, they were willing to give their lives to their ideals and to endure the rigours of hunger strike and separation from friends and family for their beliefs. Young mothers in particular suffered during the long months of incarceration. However, history has not remembered them in the same way as their patriotic brothers. In fact, until very recently, they've been virtually ignored. The story of women revolutionaries looking middle in Kilmainham Jail has almost passed from memory. I think you'll all agree that the exhibition is fantastic and gives a voice to all those women involved in 1916. I'd like to say well done and co-gorgeous to Francis on producing such fabulous work. I believe the exhibition will also be going on in Monaghan at a later stage. Francis is originally from the Sticks, and will tour the libraries of South Dublin County during 1916. So Falcha Roe of a Lake Oaks, Gur my uncle.
Thanks very much for everybody coming. It's great to see everybody here. I'd like to thank the South Dublin County Council and the libraries for doing this today. Quite a few women in the past that helped promote it 10 years ago. Niamh O'Sullivan, who Sarah Mayor mentioned. I suppose for me, when I went to Kilmainham Jail, I'm shocked that these women were there, and there's all sorts of graffiti in the jail that the women put up on the walls up when they were incarcerated. And Niamh said that they were forgotten and they should have been remembered, or etc. etc. So I just said at the time, I'm going to paint them because they deserve to be remembered. They did what they did, and you can read like a foot script under each painting that gives you a little bit of a description of what they did. It's from Sinead McCool's book, that lady who did a lot of writing in the past on them. I think, and I'm not going to try not to say too much, but there's two things I want to say. The first thing is that the, I get my thoughts together on this one, is that, yeah, 100 years ago, right, we had our rising, and it was the birth of our independence, right? And it's another, I think, 7 years, and some people might know this better than me, so you can correct me, is women didn't even have a vote until 1922. I could be wrong on that, but I think it's 22. And I kind of think that if these women had got into government, and, you know, I'm not going on about gender quotas, even though I believe in them, that if these women had been in government, I think this country would be a different country. And it's a pity, you know, it's a pity that there aren't more press here. I did invite them to celebrate these women and what they did, and we should have more women, you know, elected. Because my beliefs in women is that they are less about winning and more about taking care of, if that makes any sense. So I'm not going to go on too much about that. But if you can read about what they did and who they were. The last thing is, when the mayor spoke about what she was standing for this year, and it's about women, I asked her then straight that day when she was elected, could we do the exhibition and would you launch it, and can we donate some of the money, if there's money raised tonight, towards a charity or an organisation. So Saoirse Women's Refuge is one, and the other is CityWise, which is an educational facility in West Tallaght, which is an amazing, inspiring facility. I don't know much about the Saoirse Women, but I know if you buy a print alike, they're €150, all the money's going towards those charities. So if it's a great present, only £150. So if you do want to buy one, I suppose I could say Sarah, take the money. Come and talk to me, or I'm not sure who to talk to, but if you do want one, they are available, and it's going towards a good cause. I won't be getting any drinking credits out of it. Thanks very much for coming. Thank you.
Foggy.